Hi, it's Cinnamon Cooney. You're with the Art Sherpa. You're in my studio, but my studio transformed. Tonight, I'm going to be painting jellies. On the mic, you're going to have my sweet husband, John Cooney, who's going to be helping you guys out if you have questions or anything going on. How are you guys
How's
doing?
How's it going,
are you
everybody?
Ready for our blacklight party?
We're getting ready to go.
Are we ready to go?
I think so. We seem to be up and going.
We're up and going? All right, so like, what do you need for a blacklight party? Well, guess what? You can paint these jellyfish even if you don't have blacklight paint. You can paint these jellyfish if all you have is the colors without the fluorescent or neon in front of them. It's the same principles that work, and this is just a really fun painting project. So you're gonna need a canvas, a regular canvas. If you wanna have a blacklight party, I have in the iCards, and we have, of course, had to have a blacklight painting party at home, and I hid a Intstructuable in the description along with some other people whose videos you might want to watch, because guess what this is? This is hashtag pawgustart with the creative arts collaboration. That's what we're doing right now. This is my offering for that. And if you were to search, say, hashtag pawgustart, like you see in my title, you're going to find about 300 million other amazing art videos, all with the theme animals. That's what the CAC did this month was animals. In my art card, I have a bunch of friends. In my description, I have a bunch of friends. You know, you gotta go by and see my mom, Ginger Cook Live. You know, you gotta go by and see Clive 5 Art. You know, you gotta go by and see Secret Soto. You know, you've got a whole bunch of people to go by and see. I have some special friends in, I'm not even pointing it because I don't know where it is, but in the I card,
see, they'd
go
be
check
to
out
your
as well.
Left. To your left, over there, that's right.
There's Did
a,
I do it?
There's a whole bunch of people over there. Aunt Bernie's in there.
Bernadette's in there?
Bernadette's in there.
Happy birthday, Bernadette.
Let's see here. I see Emmy the Mastermind in there. There's lots of hellos.
Hi,
Art
Emmy.
Junkies in there.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, we have so many people tonight just all coming in to say hello. I thought
we're
going to
be glowtastic or just jellytastic. It'll all work. Here's the colors you're going to need. An approximation of these colors tonight will work to get the painting done. In glow, or in regular, just bright, happy colors, I've got a green, an orange, a blue.
Let me see back over there. There we go.
In
now we
glow.
Now we can see it.
Here is the materials. In glow, I've got a green, an orange, a blue. They say it's a pink, but I don't know. It's like some kind of pink red. The purple, which doesn't really seem to glow, a yellow, and I have just our regular titanium white and our regular phthalo blue, and I have glow white. I am doing the master's touch tonight.
Yeah, it's really hard to read the label in blacklight.
Dude, it's hard to read the label if you have eyes. I'm gonna just go here.
Yeah, it's acrylic.
Look, there it
we
is.
We can see acrylic. Master's
yeah,
touch.
Master's touch acrylic. I just get that at Hobby Lobby. But like we talked about in the how to have this party at home. Sippy.
Everyone would like to see a real close up of your makeup. It seems to be glowing up nicely in there. Oh yeah, that's you can really see it. It looks like we have Crazy Pigs is asking for a shout out.
Who is?
Crazy Pigs. It's I'm guessing that
Crazy Pigs?
It's CRAZEEPIGG 413. It's so I'm guessing that's Crazy Pig.
Crazy Pig.
Crazy Pig.
Pig
and
or
I mean
pig?
Like every pig, PIG.
Oh my goodness. Ah, Crazy Pig. Like it's amazing we get a shout out done accomplished in the studio at all. I'm painting regular assorted acrylic brushes. I've got an angle, a couple brights, another angle, and some detail rounds. And I spray painted them with my glow paint so I could see them. And these are just the Simply Simmons by Dollar and Rally. And they were just really nice brush, really economical. Whatever brushes you have will work.
And for anyone out there who's just joining us, sometimes there can be some trouble with your browser refreshing. So it may, if the screen is black, but you still see you still hear audio, just try refreshing your browser. Sometimes
and if you're having trouble commenting, that may be a YouTube thing. We've got a message into them because we can't seem to see why you wouldn't be able to comment. It's supposed to just let you comment. It's supposed to allow you to. So we're working on that.
So what are we painting tonight?
Tonight, as I showed you at the beginning, we're going to paint jellyfish.
Jellyfish.
Jellyfish are just one of those fun, easy things to paint that, I don't know, they just always bring a lot of joy. And honestly, they're the foundation for painting glasses and clear things, weirdly. So it's a good thing to paint on a regular day. And that was my first animal for the hashtag pawgustart. I think Claire Stuckey in my art card did a jellyfish too. And we didn't even talk first.
We have
sippy.
We have someone sippy. It's like a sippy break. So over there, let me show everyone your sippy. Where is it over there?
It's glowing.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. I'm holding it. Okay, I'll hold it here.
Oh, there it goes.
It's a glow sippy.
I'm having to. I'm multitasking.
He's really actually. I move suddenly and without warning, and he is really good at figuring out where the heck I am.
Right now, I've got like one control board.
We're gonna take our phthalo blue. And you can either take your titanium white or your glow white. I'm going to take my glow white. And I'm going to paint this background in. Now, these are going to be cute in glow or not in glow. It's all cute no matter what. And I'm going to resist putting my brush in my little champagne that I'm drinking tonight. I'm celebrating.
What are you celebrating?
Blacklight painting party in the studio.
Having a blacklight painting party.
And that's what I'm celebrating. Is this going to happen a lot? Yeah. Gosh, I hope you guys like this because blacklight painting has been the most fun ever. Like, I think art is fun on a good day. Blacklight painting is so fun.
Looks like Maricha and Ian are all set up for painting.
Yes, Maricha's been doing research. She's been doing some research, which is fantastic. And testing. She happened to have a black light. And I love that Ian is doing some too, huh?
That's what she says.
That's fantastic.
Now, are you starting off with a white canvas or a black canvas?
This is a white canvas. You could start off with the black canvas. What I found when I did all that crazy testing on all the paints,
mm-hmm.
was that the black canvases were great and fantastic. And if you had incredibly high quality paint with a high pigment load, it would work lovely. But if you didn't, it wouldn't. And most of the over-the-counter at the craft store paints, every paint line has a set of neons. It's incredible.
Yep.
All your paint needs to say is neon and fluorescent. I'd mm-hmm. like to move at him. It needs to say is neon and fluorescent. And then it's going to glow under the black light. Now, if it says glow in the dark, it will glow. But sometimes it just glows all of it. The color of my nails, you just get that color. And that's the only color. But some of the lines, like Martha Stewart, have specific colors, even in the glow in the dark.
Most fluorescent paint should fluoresce under black light.
I have not found a paint labeled yet fluorescent that did not.
Yeah, that's so. Neon or not, fluorescent should be the key word we're looking for.
Well, or neon.
Or is it so?
Neon seem to, the pink neon, the green neon, the orange neon, and the red neon always seem to glow. Blue neon is kind of iffy. Purple neon, you got to really go to the airbrush paint. And there's a whole thing about this, all this research on my last live broadcast, which is still up, and we're putting together a fast 8-minute version of it.
Yep. And we'll be experimenting in the future with pigments, with fluorescent pigments you can add to your own paint.
Yeah.
And see how that works. There are pigments you can add, but
it's pricey.
Yeah, they're expensive, and we want to do some research and experimentation before we hand that off to you guys.
I'm not ready to be like Clive and make all my own mediums like he does over there in Wales. That's one of the things that's going on in his current hashtag is he's making his own thick modeling paste.
Wow.
But given that he said it was like 8 pounds a jar, I don't blame him.
Yeah.
It's like, I'd be making it then too. Why is modeling paste? So you can kind of, I'm going to show this to you. Look, it's just glowing.
Oh, it just so washes out there. The black light plays a funny thing with the exposure settings on there. Because you can definitely see it.
Oh yeah.
Well, no, you can definitely see it.
Okay.
The difference between what's been painted and what hasn't.
Wow, because it looks so. It's what it is right now. If there's some way we can fix it, that would be great, because what it is right now is just a beautiful luminescent blue.
Yeah, and you, it definitely translates there. There's the white of the canvas picks up the purple hue just naturally from the black light. That's what's the closest to the UV. So,
well, this is just phthalo blue and the black white paint. Oh. Yeah, I like to mess with you.
You do. And I push the wrong button sometimes.
Oh, okay.
Did you know we have somebody from Estonia tonight watching
us? Estonia?
I think that's a cool place. I actually have to completely agree with that. So Curly is from Estonia.
Shout out to Estonia.
That's right. I wonder if Janet from Estonia knows who Curly is.
I think it's a big place, John. At least big enough where they don't know each other.
Oh, no, as a pop star from Estonia.
Oh, like, because there's just all pop stars? What?
Well, no, because she is a famous pop star from that place.
Oh, that's right, Curly. I'm sorry. I'm hipping up. Hipping up.
It's like Madonna being from England.
Yeah. You got my palette going instead of me, baby.
There you go.
It's okay. I'm just putting on a cap. They were missing nothing. They weren't missing a whole lot of the cap. Struggling with a cap. So if you wanted to have black light in your house, guess what? It's really cheap and it's really easy. We covered that in the both my Instructuable and in that how to have a blacklight painting party at home, and it'll be in the quick one. But it was like the bulbs were not expensive.
No, the bulbs aren't. They're about $4 or $5 a piece, the screw-in light bulbs. And the big fluorescent light bulbs are about $15 a bulb. And you need two of those for a fixture. So.
Yeah, but just the table lamps.
Just the table lamps,
and
yeah.
I think two table lamps on either side of an easel, and you'd get the same amount of glow I'm getting right now.
Yeah. You'd get quite a bit out of there.
So this is the thing. This is happening right now everywhere. Everything I'm seeing right now everywhere is black light parties.
There seems to be a lot of interest in black light parties, and there's some people here showing up to watch black light parties.
That's right.
So.
Or are they just like, what is Sherpa doing tonight? Why is she painting black light? But again, like I said, if you did this exact same technique, you would get a very similar result. And I'm gonna post this picture done, of course, all the places that I post, the Pinterest and the Facebook and the Instagram. And I may also include what it looks like without the black light, because sometimes it's very, very, very different.
Mm-hmm.
And so I don't know if you can see it, but I've been like crazy with my brush stroke.
Yeah, that's it's looking really good. Now why don't you bring it up to the screen now that it's got that. Oh, yeah, that you can really see that as you pan it back and forth, a lot of that different crazy brush stroke. And it looks a bit oversaturated on the screen. And
I think it is.
Well, it's also because, you know, we're playing with some funny colors of light spectrum that aren't normally used here. So we're working it out.
We're working it out.
We're working it out.
You know what I didn't work out?
What's that?
My towel, which is way, way away from me. Towel is farther away from me.
Hold on.
Than my ability, my tether. Right. I'm mic'd and I have a tether. And if I walk out too far, it just cleans my clock. Hey, everybody. He's getting my towel. Towel! Towel! Sometimes it's nice to have
okay,
a towel.
I'm back.
Oh, some other surprise materials I might play with tonight. Are these fabric sprays? Yeah, fabric sprays will work on a canvas, anybody's canvas. The reason a lot of artists sometimes won't work with these is they're not highly archival, but at the point we've embraced blacklight painting, we know this paint is not forever.
Yeah.
It's not. It's a couple of years of glowy glow. No more glow. But the fun is amazing. I've been doing a lot of live broadcasting and painting with it. And I am really into it. How many people are blacklight painting tonight?
How many people are? I know we've got at least a couple people painting along with us tonight. So it'd be good to, if we could get everyone to tell us who's painting along with us, and if we could
That's really good.
You know, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe as you can to help let us know that you're out there and that you love us.
Clicky.
And we'll be able to keep on doing this. What are you doing?
I'm looking at them.
You're looking at them? Are they in there? Do you see them? look way inside there. I think you might see Bob. He's in there.
Bob's in there.
He's there. I promise.
Is Bernadette still in there?
I think Bernadette's still in there too.
Birthday Bernadette.
All right.
Okay.
Sippy sippy.
I sippied.
I'm sippy sippying.
Oh, you're sippy
I'm
sippying.
I'm sippy sippying.
John's sippy sippying too. So, like, what we decided to do was grow up and have a YouTube show.
That's right.
In black light.
See, there's my, I'm picking up a beer button.
Are you getting an echo?
No, I just put up the.
So, I found these black light paints sometimes struggle with drying, so I'm going to hit them with the hair dryer. Right. I don't know how John's going to make your experience with my hair dryer more pleasant, but he'll figure out a way.
See, we can totally take care of this while she's using the hair dryer. Hang in there. She's almost done.
All right, I'm going to do most. I'm going to get my favorite brush out, the half inch angle brush. And my glue paint. Isn't that cool? That just worked out really, really well.
What's that? How we painted them?
Yeah, I was really happy with that.
It did turn out pretty good. Yeah. So we can see what you're doing.
So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to...
Where are you going
to
go? You keep moving around.
What I got to do?
Nothing. You're good.
Oh.
You keep dodging around. You're trying to get away from the camera.
I'm doing my best. And I'm weirdly going to start on my violet, the color that's the least... Bob was pointing out to me why it was the least photoreactive, which I think it's probably true, but I'm going to mess with it by adding a little white to it. I'm going to take it to Pandora.
It popped up, yeah. It pops a little bit more.
So I'm going to put in the bell of my jellyfish kind of in this upper right corner over here. And the thing about them is they're just a very simple shape. I mean, it's really, you're just kind of, they have these wonderful little round bell bodies that come down. And I'm going to just follow along. Can we see this, John, in the black light?
You know, it's not, it
wow.
sort of. Now, there was a question.
I'm going to do this. There it goes.
Yeah, that popped
Here's
up.
Here's the shape.
Now, there was a quick question.
Yeah.
Donna asked, she said that deco art makes a glow-in-the-dark writer paint.
Yes.
She said, I couldn't find white, so do you think I could mix acrylic white and the glow-in-the-dark? Would that work?
So what I found was that the glow-in-the-dark paint actually works as a white a lot of times when you're mixing with the paints, except when you're not in blacklight. And then it doesn't impact the color. It was real interesting doing color mixing boards with the paint in the blacklight and then taking it out into regular light. And yeah, you can actually get a little glow-in-the-dark, but then it won't just glow-in-the-dark. It'll be photoreactive, but it won't necessarily glow in the dark. So I say just go with it, like, pure.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to switch my color plan here to this bright color.
What is that bright color?
I think this is their pink. I think this is what they're saying.
Kind of pinkish?
Pink is. And I'm going to just bell this guy up with the pink.
Oh, we had some really good ideas that came up during the break.
Okay, cool.
Which was next time during the blow dryer phase, we could do trivia questions.
Oh, that is a good idea. Now I'm going to do the dark. I like that actually. I like that very much actually. Here's a trivia question if you're watching everybody's live show. What mountain was my mother Ginger on when we got stuck on the log truck and she fell off and her legs went out from underneath her and the loggers thought they killed her?
That's a good question.
What mountain?
I don't know.
I feel like anyone that can answer that deserves a prize. But it was discussed on my mom's live show.
It was discussed on your mom's. So.
Ginger Cook Live.
Oh, well, they were saying that the. Let me see if I can share our volumes turned up here. They were saying that it's a little quieter than normal. So I'll see if I can.
Is our thing quiet? Am I plugged in?
You're plugged in.
Am I turned on?
You are. You are turned on. I'm just going to bring the gain up a little bit and see if that helps everyone.
So I've got this pink here, and I'm going to mix it with my white to get a pinkier pink. And I'm going to come around the underside of the bell. And this is going to be a brighter color. The underside of a jellyfish's bell. And if you're just doing these jellyfish in regular color, you can do jellyfish in any old color on the planet. It's really about the shadow, the shape, and the flow. And just having fun in the color. All it's about.
So Marty says Pike's Peak.
Thing to paint. Huh?
Marty says Pike's Peak.
That is the mountain my dad opened, but it was Grouse Mountain.
It's Grouse Mountain.
In Canada. In Canada, because she was fighting with her sister, and we got lost on Grouse Mountain. Well, okay, so it's actually my fault, because I wouldn't get back in the gondola, because I'm afraid of heights. So technically, it may be our fault, my fault, that we were lost on Grouse Mountain, because I have a whole thing with heights, and I could not get back in the gondola to come back down. I got up, but John has been with me when I've done my stuck thing. Haven't you, John?
You're creative.
Yeah. He talks me down. He's a nice voice, so he talks me down.
So, that's looking really sharp.
See? And I've kind of let some of the blue show through.
Yeah, it's popping out really nicely.
Yeah, it does. It comes in real easy, real nice. Just a happy, happy thing. I'm going to have just a little...
And there's no right or wrong on this.
Just no, there really isn't on the jellyfish. And my brush pressure is very light. It's undersea angry wet cat light.
So it's light like you're touching. It's man of war.
It's man of war light.
It's man of war light touching
one. Jellyfish light. Actually, it's runaway. You don't even touch a box jellyfish. You just run.
If you know what a box of jellyfish is, you probably are in trouble.
Yeah.
If you live where they're at, they're...
Or you watch a lot of Discovery Channel like I do. Now, my favorite part of doing jellyfish, I'm going to let that dry for a little bit, is the tentacles.
The tentacles.
Tentacles. I wish we had little brushes in, because the little brushes love to do the tentacles.
They do. We can go get some. I know where there's some at.
No, not mine.
You don't want your little brushes in
there? No, I love my little brushes, but not tonight. So how I do this, and I'm going to kind of turn this towards you, is I do this little wiggle stroke. I'm on the edge of my brush. And I just wiggle it back and forth. And that is how I get the first of my tentacles. And it's really fun to do.
It looks really good.
Stressed weak man. This is your painting. You can just jellyfish up till the cows come home.
It's awesome. It looks like lightning and water.
It does, right? And we're just kind of going to do some of these little squiggles down. Another fun tool to use on these, if you have them, if you happen to be a mixed media artist, is of course the paint writers, the paint pens, mm-hmm. the puffy paints, all those work really great. So my little tentacles are going to be flowing out this way today.
I think it's getting close to being sippy sippy time.
I agree that it's sippy sippy time. I'm feeling a need for the sippy sippy.
I think everyone out there.
So can you guys see those little tentacles coming in?
They look really good.
Tentacles. See, just jellyfish.
Mmm.
I'm drinking some sort of, I don't know what I'm drinking.
Champagne. It's right behind you. So on the table behind you, over there, you can pick it up and see what it is. There's a wonderful bottle right there.
It's a, this bottle is actually pink, bright pink in real life. And it's a Brut Rose, and it's an Anna Quarter New. Mm. And I only say this because the nice wine lady at Kroger knows I don't understand wine. She's like, this is a 90-point champagne. And I guess it's 90 out of 100. And I figured that's like basically an A.
That's basically an A.
That's basically an A.
All right.
Which is why I am not going to be a sommelier. Ever. All right, see, so we got some little tentacles in, and they're really fun. I wish this was picking up all the detail here.
Now, after we're done, we're going to kick on the overhead so that people can see this in regular light as well.
I have no idea, and you never know what it's going to look like when the overhead goes on.
We don't know.
It's really scary. So I'm going to come back with just my pink, and I'm going to work this little edge here and strengthen it up, and I'm going to bring this up, these little brush strokes up. And this is all you're going to do in your little jellyfish. Jelly. Sometimes you can paint little friends of jellyfish that are swimming with it, because a lot of times they like to swim in those little groups.
We can have jelly friends.
Jelly friends. How many jelly friends do you have? Too many jellies. Too many. I don't know what I'm talking about. So So, I mean, I know what I'm talking about, like, artistically. I'm just like... and I'm just trying to keep my brush out of the water. So that's, like, what I did with my pink. But is that going to be all I'm going to want to do? That's not going to be all I'm going to want to do, right?
What else are you
going to
do?
I'm going to want to do other stuff. So I'm going to get some of my...
Orange.
I like my orange. It's so happy. And I'm going to come up top here, and I'm going to add a little bit of orange. Ooh. A little bit of the orange. A little bit of the orange. Maybe bring it down a little bit. Pressure is, again, line jellyfish. But no, we have no box jellyfishes here today.
Angry jellyfish pressure?
Angry jellyfish. Like... Can you imagine how completely off the evolutionary reservation the jellyfish would have to be upset? Because, like, by definition, they're not.
I don't know.
I've been watching that ridiculous show, Zoo, and I'm sorry if you love Zoo. I'm watching it with you, but I'm struggling.
Why are you struggling
to hang in with Zoo. But I'm a completionist, so I'm going to watch it all the way to the end. I'm going to add some orange to some of my tentacles. I'm going to go back where I had some and hit them with the highlight of orange.
So how many tentacles does a jellyfish have?
I don't know. Am I supposed to know that? Are you asking them that?
I don't know. Is there? I imagine there is a set number per species. But
internet.
Like, I'm sure the intertubes will tell us somewhere.
Somewhere. Somebody will be like, down thumb, you didn't know jellyfish tentacle numbers. I down thumb you.
Well, Bob asked. So I don't know.
Bob asked?
I don't know. Is it, you know... It's a good question. I didn't know the answer.
It's a really good question. I probably have already messed up that answer. This is an art jellyfish, and it has an artful number of tentacles.
It has many.
Many. Many, many tentacles. See, I mean, this is just how simple and chill this is. I got to tell you guys, if you can, just go get the bulbs, pull a lampshade off a lamp, turn out your lights and get some neon paint. I think it was like you could get those little neon paints from Americana for 59 cents a piece. It was not, and I had that other set that was $2.99. All the colors were in it. Just like two little, you could just have this and you'd be just like everything that is not working in my life. I mean, I've had Claire and all my friends over here. I'm going to have my mom over here just for fun to blacklight paint.
Oh, yeah.
And y'all get to blacklight paint with me at least once a week now.
Yeah. Now, it's thank you, everyone, for coming in, commenting and liking and subscribing everything and commenting in here in the chat with us. We really appreciate everyone being in here.
He's so sweet. And he's right. Thank you. I'm going to get yellow paint.
Yellow paint. There's some yellow paint.
Yellow paint. And I'm going to add that to my jellyfish. Very lightly. And stuff is going to mix, which is sort of interesting. I'm adding that in the belt. And you can just see that just... And again, I have no idea other than I better have, tones down on one end. Oh, it's so pretty. Isn't it kind of pretty, though?
Oh, it is.
It just... It's not long. It's not hard.
Interestingly, Don DeJerry just said that up to 15 tentacles... from each corner of the belly can grow and reach up to 10 feet.
What about the little minor stringy tentacles? Because I'm about to put a bunch of those in.
I think there's little ones and big ones. So I imagine that it's different for each critter.
So now I'm just going on the edge of my loaded brush, and instead of doing squigglies, I'm doing swirls out.
Ooh.
And we're not going to pay attention to jellyfish anatomy. We're going to pay attention to art design philosophy.
This is a pretty
jellyfish. So, but I'll tell you a little art tip, Sherpa tip. Whenever you're giving a gift of a painting, if you're giving it to somebody who specializes in the field, then you got to do the jellyfish tentacle number, because otherwise it'll just hang on their wall and make them crazy. It does. So that's the only problem with giving, my husband likes cars, and that's hard for me sometimes to do. See, I'm just doing this swirl down.
And Sky knew the answer to your trivia question from earlier.
She did?
She did.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. I don't know. I got to do something for Sky. I got to think on that. Oh, I have the best plaque from Sammy. Hi, Sammy. I love my plaque. My plaque is amazing. I don't think there's any way to see it on the wall right now. It's in black light, but I love my plaque. Thank you. So pretty. Love it. Yeah, I got this beautiful piece of art from Sky's Little Brush Sammy. And I so appreciated it. And it's just beautiful. And I'm so grateful.
Think there are 15 on each corner of the belly.
Okay, well then I think
I see all of them.
It's pretty good.
It's good. It's great. I think it's pretty anatomically correct.
You know, so we have that kind of going on in there. And I think that's sort of fun. And that's really, I mean, honestly, it's just that fun to do a jellyfish. I'm going to get some of my blue because I have it and it's neon. And I'm going to put it kind of around some of my jellyfish to give it like a glow. I don't know what that's going to do to my actual background. But sometimes it's just fun. And we did look, there's a way to light these paintings all the time.
That's right, yeah. So we went and looked at some painting light fixtures that you can get on Amazon and different light framing stores. And they're generally fairly inexpensive. You can get them on under $20 usually. And they sort of mount to the top of a picture. And they have a bulb inside there that looks kind of like an aquarium bulb. So the trick is just finding one that's big enough that houses your little blacklight bulb when you screw it in there, and that should work just fine. And then all of a sudden you have a blacklight that illuminates your painting during the day. It works great.
This is blacklight because it's glowing. I don't know if you can see that it's glowing around the jellyfish. And I'm going to add a little bit. I find this to be very interesting, so I'm going to add a little bit of this kind of swirled in here. Sort of fun to just mix up the paint and have a little good time going on. You know? And honestly, it's this easy and this fun, and we're nearly done, which is crazy. Does anyone else think it is crazy?
It's really coming together.
Wrapping up our jellyfish. I'm going to get some of my glow-in-the-dark white. I'm going to work it here,
little highlight.
Creating a highlight along my little squiggle. You guys can see that. And then I think I'm going to add some white tentacles in here. Just want to feel like this feeling of flowiness. Make this sort of like little shape over here. If you guys can see what I'm... Oh, totally can see
it. Oh, it's standing out. Oh, yeah, it looks really good. The painterly brush strokes are definitely popping out. It's interesting how this the same techniques where you use to blend the color and all of that in your regular paints applies right here in Blacklight just the same.
It pretty much does, man. Painting rules, be painting rules, be painting rules. And they work. So I'm just looking... What I always say is look for the spaces... In art, it's like, what can I leave out? But sometimes the art is like, where do I have a space that feels truly empty and devoid that needs something? And you want to make sure that you add it. Now, I feel like normally I'd be like, this be my jellyfish. This be jellies.
It's a good looking jelly.
And you could be done here. And if you were just painting with me, you'd be like, I could paint 5 more jellies. And that is absolutely true.
You could put little jellies in.
You could put little jellies in. You could do decorations all around your jellies. You know, you can do them big and small and all of that. But I want to experiment and show you what some of these spray paints will do.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to spray paint some of this up. Trying to give it kind of a water effect, and then if I short splatters, I get these.
Yeah, you can see it kind of gives it that little spray look.
Kind of a little bit of a water effect. I just wanted to see what it would do and drip and play. Sometimes it goes bad on you when you experiment. Sometimes it goes good. I'm going to get some of these pink splatters.
Little dots. And this one won't sting you. This is definitely a...
This is a friendly jelly.
This is a friendly jelly.
and I'm going to let it drip. I'm even going to tap the painting to encourage it.
Is this a technical tap that you're giving it there?
Dude. I don't know if you can see how it's not picking up the paint.
Yeah, you can see the you could totally see all of the water drips and the water effect that it's creating.
Yeah, it's fun. I mean, if you have these, you don't have to do it. You could throw some paint at it. Also, you know, you can layer it up and just have some fun. You can hit it with some puff paints. Got some orange here. Getting a little crazy now, but it's just fun for me to do. I don't know if you can see the oranges coming down.
You can see the little oranges all pooling up now.
So you just got to ask yourself, how would I play? And if you take something out, I see this happening all the time to artists. They took something out that they needed. You just come and you just get some paint and you just go ahead and put it right back in. You don't even worry about it. Wherever you need it, you just put it right back in. Wherever it's bothering you. Let the canvas dry. And then, voila! Jelly, jelly, jelly!
Jelly, jelly.
So, who's painting jellies next? Who's going to jelly it up?
We have lots of people ready to paint jellies next. There are a lot of them. We're going to be looking for some UV paint and see about getting some supplies so that we can get in and do this.
You guys want to do this with me because we're going to take you to Pandora.
Absolutely.
We're going to let it go in the snow with a couple of famous sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Glow cats are coming up this weekend.
Glow cats?
So we're going to have a couple cats this weekend. We're going to keep broadcasting live.
Yep.
We're going to do that fire cat that I posted on Facebook. We're going to do him one day. So that's not a glow painting. That's just a regular painting. That's also going to be hashtag pawgustart. And also for hashtag pawgustart, I'm going to do the blacklight glow cats, which you could also do in glow or not in glow. Just enjoy the weird craziness. I feel like when this is dry, it shows up better. I feel like if I dry it.
Oh no, you're gonna turn that on. I gotta de-mic you.
Can you?
I can. So I can slow. I can. But see, I don't have any trivia questions ready. Though is the problem. Now I'm just stuck here talking to you guys while she's over there blow drying, having to impromptu come up with ideas on what to say. See, this just doesn't work at all. I'm gonna call a mulligan here and just go for a sippy sippy. I think that, you know, that's my parachute cord. I'm just going to pull it right now. Sippy, sippy. It doesn't really help, though, does it? All right, so. There's 15 seconds she's left me alone, and I've already lost it. So. She'll be back, I promise. I see some of you got to be having fun at the mild panic that I must be having here, just sitting here waiting for her, having no idea how long it'll take, having to come up with random things to sing. Somebody volunteered for me to sing. I think that's a bad idea. All right, well, here she's back.
See if that is showing it any better.
It is. I was just saying, you left me all alone to talk to them with no prepared.
Here, maybe at this angle, can you see all the drips and wateriness?
You know, the drips and water, you can definitely see the water in it, wateriness in the drips there now. Yeah, it's definitely starting to show up.
Now, see, it's not picking up, and I think it's the camera, is that these are pink and orange drips. This is better with your real eyes. We're going to have to get a special camera or lens or get my husband's full spectrum camera out.
I will see if I can do that. I'll see if I can get the full spectrum camera up.
Or
and set
up. Clive has some bandwidth, he'll come by and be like, set your camera to this crazy person.
Yeah, we're not.
Because he would tell me, he's actually a good photographer, so yes. He would like tell me what was going on.
We just plug things in and flip switches until they work.
But I feel really happy with this. I feel like you follow those basic things. See, like, look at all the different ways we made jellies. And this was puffy paints and different things. These were all the different ways that we made jellies.
Lots of different jellies.
Okay, there we go. Lots of, so.
Oh, I like that jelly. That's a jelly family.
Yeah, I made a jelly family. artful jelly.
That's a very artful jelly.
So you can kind of see the point is you can do this in your art journal. You can do this on a canvas. You can pretty much do this anywhere. I let my kids, when I'm done with my blacklight paint, I just let them have at the blacklight paint and paint on paper under the blacklight, and they are super satisfied with that. They think that is crazy fun. Maybe I can show that. Do we have the lamp?
The lamp? It's behind you.
This isn't the Intstructuable, but here is our lamp conversion.
It's not terribly difficult conversion.
No.
Put a black light in it and spray it.
It's exactly it. But I wrote an Intstructuable about it. You should go there.
In case you need help with spray painting and screwing a light bulb in, we've got an Intstructuable for you.
In the for sure place that I found white paint, and this is in the short one, and this is in the long how to have a blacklight painting party studio at home, and this is the Intstructuable, was the Lucas. I really liked their white. But anything that's like, this one says fluorescent reflexive white, but if it just says fluorescent, you can go to town with it. For sure, probably neon will get you through. Like, I haven't really found a neon besides blue or purple that didn't really glow.
Yep.
Bright isn't gonna do it.
Now,
did you guys like it?
There seems to be a lot of people out here that really like it. And they were curious when we're going to be doing another one. So we're going to try to do our weekday shows in the evenings because we have kids. And that is where, you know, trying to hit the central time zones in the U.S. Now, on the weekends, though, because we know we have a lot of people in overseas locations and with strange hours, we're going to try to do some daytime and morning
shows. Well, they're strange hours to us, but they're normal hours to them.
They're normal for them locally, yes. But they would be odd hours if you're in, say, Houston, Texas. So it'd be where people are tuning in right now, and it's 5 a.m. and 3 a.m.
Have we had 5 a.m. and 3 a.m.?
We do.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
Artist More Jackie. It says it's almost 5 a.m., and she had to get up there. Yeah.
Talk about a trooper. You got to share your jellyfish with me on the Facebook page, then. Oh, my goodness. Stay up to 5 in the morning. Jellyfish now, on the Facebook page.
Starwolf.
Weird mood.
Starwolf was asking about, won't any white...
Starwolf is
Starwolf.
Here?
Starwolf.
Is he here?
He is. Do you know Starwolf?
Yes, he does very cool space art with pastels and a unique process that is unique to him. Oh.
There you go.
And I think he did a pawgustart. He was going to do a pawgustart, but he had a birthday too.
Well, so asked if won't any bright white paint, though, show up the same way under bright white? It won't, will it? You really need to find one that has a luminescent quality about it rather than a flat quality about it. So like the titanium whites. Zinc whites.
I mean, you could get a bunch of white paint and get it under black light and see if it glows. You could. My husband suggested that I get a handheld black light from, what was it, Bed Bath & Beyond.
Bed Bath & Beyond, yeah. They have they're for you to check, you know, hotel rooms and things to make sure that there's no, you know, unsavory places that you may want them to come tidy up before you were to stay the night at the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
They also work to help you find those fluorescent paints and things.
Yeah, don't use it at the hotel. It's going to make you super unhappy. Just do that like one time in your life, and then you're like, I can't stay anywhere now.
Yeah.
So some things that have been seen cannot be unseen. That's a hat tip to Maricha.
you mean the junk and data girl who I can't pronounce her name?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just want to make sure I talk about the right person.
I dig my dig glue nails. I know, I'm like a child over here, but that is really, I'm telling you,
I think we're just playing in the black light now.
It is just playing in the black light. Like, I will do painting again.
It's
and
sippy
again
sippy.
And again.
I'm just going to call it sippy sippy.
Sippy sippy.
And then we're going to have to.
I'm going to see you guys some more this weekend. Cool?
Yeah.
We're going to come back and meet me at this easel really soon?
Yep, I think so. Bye bye.